to see that I would do anything for you. Baby, if you leave, I don't know what I would do.
Live from Fairfield, California, right here at Holy Spirit Prayer Meeting. Please give a warm welcome for Pat Garcia. Wondering why I have my notepad here. I didn't really rehearse this, but I've been thinking about it for the past few weeks. So, and that's all this goes with. All right, so, it's glad to be here at prayer meeting. And I feel like this is an amazing place right here. Because, I mean, let's face it, I'm no expert on the Bible, per se. So, I'm glad I can come to this place and grow in my faith and get clarification on certain things. Like, here's one thing that I was kind of thinking about. Is I never really fully understood it. Like, we all know, like, Jesus Christ is, like, God in human likeness, like, coming down here, right? But here's what I don't fully understand. Like, did he really know that he's God? Like, was he conscious about it? Because I was wondering, like, he could just walk up to Pontius Pilate and be like, yo, I'm gonna go get crucified for the sins of mankind, but I just want you to let you know, I could smash you, bro. Smash you, bro. You don't even know. Like, who do you think created all this? Like, the sun, the moon, the earth? Like, this is all me, son. All me. Oh, Caleb, that's all me. Stay true, that's all me. Came up, that song, you know, like, oh, damn, son, oh, damn, I feel like it's crazy the way, like, rap music has evolved nowadays, like, just the crazy lyrics. I mean, one thing that annoyed me about rappers and R&B singers is they always gotta talk about, like, other people's girls and stuff. Like, the lyrics is like, jet set all around the world, I'm riding around with your girl. Like, yo, like, that pisses me off. I hate that. But it's cool, because I studied Bastekan at Jared's house. Martial arts and stuff like that. And I'm working out, I'm on this 30-day push-up challenge, and I'm losing weight, I'm trying to gain muscle.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna buy a ticket to, like, a 2 Chainz concert. And I'm gonna take out the security guard. I'm gonna sneak my way into the backstage, and I'm gonna be like, hey, 2 Chainz, guess what? I don't even have a girlfriend. How many people saw that punchline? All right, well, I thought about that. But so, I mean, let's say, for example, like, I did have a girlfriend, right? I would picture her as, like, my dream girl. Like, oh, my gosh, like, she would be, like, a little bit over, like, 300 pounds, and, like, long, flowing red hair, freckles, because, like, I believe that gingers are, like, God's greatest creation. They're, like, so beautiful. Like, so picture, like, a bigger version of, like, Princess Merida from Brave, like that. And I think the most beautiful thing about her, like, her most, like, seductive quality is that she never shaves, like, ever. And when she lifts her arms and all this right here, it's like the Hunger Games, you know? Like, when I'm in there, I'm like Katniss Everett, I'll rise up in that little tomb and be like, it's on, move! Like that. But,